The new breaker is in the house. I'm Pichi from Pichi Abo, and we are from Valencia, Spain.
And I'm Abo. So, yeah.
Okay, that's it. Yeah. Okay, we finished the interviews. So you're coming from Valencia, and you just done a big mural in Grenoble. But before we talk about the mural, can we tell us a little bit where did you start? Is it?
Pichi started in 1994. I started in the early 2000s. So yeah, we met in 2007, and we decided to go together, just to do things, do better things together. So yeah.
And did you start straight doing this style that is now your trademark, or that was more random graffiti?
No, we were doing random graffiti. In my case, I started like thanks of the hip hop thing. I started like linking that and doing pure graffiti, like tags and letters. But like as soon as we started, we were doing different things, more realistic, more focused in the technique. And through that, we were developing everything till now.
So that means that you got the skill, you both guys got the technique to paint an amazing face, hyper-realistic things.
Yeah, I think that's one of the main things that we have. Like both, we can do the same things, and both we can put more into it in the wall. So we cover each other, and it's a matter of layers, and each layer counts. So if he covers me or I cover him, it's a good thing. At the end of the wall, so yeah, we were able to do both things, and that's the fun part of everything.
Yeah, we try to represent the real life in the street art. It's like when you paint in the wall, maybe other day come one writer and cover you.
Okay, so it's a kind of mystical way to paint, or no? At least you. You represent the reality, and that's
well,
nice.
Yeah, the matter is like to trust each other, and we trust each other, and we don't have any ego, and so we just add more to the wall, and at the end the wall stops, and that's how it is. So yeah,
excellent. That's a nice story to hear. So by doing your wall, so now many artists, when they're doing huge mural, you don't video project or anything, but you're starting to put a lot of information on the wall. Then I imagine you take a picture of that, you put your image on it, and that's a kind of way to be sure that you respect the proportion and your image are perfect. Is that correct, what I'm saying?
Yeah, we use a lot of references in our backgrounds to do that. Some people like just use the architecture references. In our case, because our background needs to be like that, it's the easy way to have it. So yeah, we do that. Other artists do other techniques that it's also good, and we support that. So yeah, like we feel comfortable like we do.
And so by writing all those names or words in a graffiti style, whatever it is, bubble letters or white style or whatever, do you get the ability and the opportunity to write something on the wall before you put your character on it? Did you take advantage of that? What do you write? What did you say in the background of the piece?
So the thing is, like, we freestyle everything, and in each country that we go, each city, we absorb a lot of information, and we try to express it in the wall. So in this case, we have information like in French, we have information about the city, about hip hop, street art, about the mythology themes. So we do that, and it's a way of learning and throwing all that information to people, so people also can read the wall. And I think it's really interesting not to see just the static. It's more interesting like when people play a little bit and they try to read things, even if it's in Spanish or English or French. So it's good. Like we're super international. So yeah, we just throw information and it's freestyle.
That's great. So when people just pass through, they catch the main character, a huge statue face, but there is a lot of information that is hidden, more or less. Would you consider that as a subliminal message?
Maybe there are. No, not like I think it's interesting that people find every day something new.
I think it's good when people see first the main character, and then they realize that in the background they have information and it's graffiti on it. So they really start loving the piece. And they discover something that they normally don't love, and with it they will love it.
So how do you choose the character for this piece, for example?
In this case, it's related with the city because it's Fontaine, and his statue is the father of the sea, of the ocean. It's Poseidon. I think it's perfect for this area.
Did you get a? Did you take anything from the piece that is facing this wall? Because on the other side of the tramway, you get another piece from Serti, which is a French artist who came last year and done something. Is there any? Did you take that in consideration or not?
In this case, no. I think it's a coincidence because we normally chose the color because blue is totally water. I think it's coincidence.
Excellent. So, and when you're doing pieces, do you always choose a god, or it can be a character that is not a could be a statue, but not mythological character?
For now, I prefer represent the mythological history because it's interesting for us. And maybe in the future we can change, but I think the mythological is super interesting because you can read a lot of histories. It's super impressive.
So thank you guys for being here. Did you name the mural yet? Or
yeah, not yet. We need time, yes.
Okay, we're going to print a book, and this is going to be in the book, so we need that information, not too late.
Okay. Thank you.